Hi, I'm Vicki Jenkins, and I am the dance educator at Edison High School. Tonight, we're going to present to you 5 solos performed by junior and senior dancers. This started as just an assignment in class to create something based on a stimuli, and these dancers took their solos to the next level. We've had some time on Zoom to work on them, and now we've been in the studio a few times to really develop them. I hope you enjoy the performance tonight and the interviews getting to know the ladies. Thank you. So joining us, I have the 5 dancers that are going to be performing in Our Voices, Our Stories. I'm going to have them introduce themselves.
Hi, I'm Ashley. I'm a junior, and I've been in the dance program for 3 years.
Hi, I'm Alicia. I'm a junior, and I've been in the dance program for 3 years.
Hi, I'm JD. I'm a junior, and I've been in the dance program for 3 years.
Hi, I'm Adriana. I'm a junior, and I've been in the dance program for 2 years.
Hi, I'm Zaria, and I'm a senior, and I've been in the dance program for 3 years.
So the dancers are here today because they were chosen to complete works that we did in an assignment. So being online, I really wanted them to work on their creativity, and we had them choose a stimuli and create a solo around that. Some of the pieces were so amazing that I really wanted them to develop them further. And so they're going to talk a little bit about what their stimuli was, why they chose it, and just a little bit about the process of the piece. You know, being in this place where, you know, you come into the studio and this is, like you said, your safe space, right? You're creative and that energy, and we don't have that at home. Do you feel, in the beginning, you may have felt like, oh, I don't know if I can do this. I don't know if I want to do this. I don't know if I want to dig this deep. Do you feel in the end it was something that taught you, whether it was about dance or whether it was about just life in general? Anybody can answer kind of what that creative vulnerability did for you.
I mean, yeah, like, it definitely opened my eyes, and, like, it's not about just, like, the movement. It's about, like, what you do with the move and everything.
Dance teacher, hard hat. Yeah, so, I mean, that's the thing. You know, a lot of times we're taught steps, right? And we're not taught, you know, you got to tell a story because the audience doesn't always know, oh, what, that was a fabulous jeté or a plié or a pirouette, you know? And then to feel that. So what would be your overall takeaway with this? Do you like to choreograph? Do you hope to do something again for this? Alicia, what was your overall?
I love choreographing. Mm-hmm. I make dances up all the time. I've been making dances up since I was like 3. So this is always fun for me, and I always like to do something different from the last time I choreographed something. So overall, I just love choreographing, and I really like this, and I like that we do a solo concert because I've always wanted to do a solo.
And out of all of you ladies, how many, let's tell our audience, how many of you have never really had professional, like, dance classes?
2.
Yeah. That's, go ahead, yeah, let's talk about that. So what has it been like having dance at Edison High and not only being able to dance, but then being able to create something? What has that been like for you?
It's honestly been, like, really shocking. And, like, it's something to reflect on for yourself because, like, I feel really proud of myself. Like, first off, I would never ever think, like, I'll be doing a solo. Like, at first, you know, you get anxious or you get nervous or something like that. But, like, once you're in the moment, once you're dancing, once you're, like, you feel the music in your body, you're, like, in a whole nother dimension. Mm-hmm. So it just feels good. And also, like, going back to your question, I really never gotten, like, any professional work, or I've never actually been to an academy outside of Edison High School. So just being able to get this experience since freshman year to my junior year is really something that I'm gonna carry on with my life, and, like, I'm just overall thankful for this opportunity.
Great. And how about those of you that do have a lot of experience? You know, how is this different from what you do in your dance studios?
Okay, so in my dance studio is, like, I'm a competitive dancer. I've been competing since I was 5, and I'm 16 now. And what it is, you just learn a routine, you perfect it, you do it at competitions, you keep doing that routine from September till like July, and then you do the same thing the next year. So I never really got a chance to like choreograph something of my own. So doing this was a challenge for me because I'm so used to just getting choreo thrown at me and doing it, memorizing it. But this actually came from me and what I've been taught throughout all my teachers, and just kind of showing who I am with my choreo. So yeah.
But choreographing this, it was a bit of a challenge because, like JD said, I'm so used to just memorizing choreography and putting it out there. And I've had, like, choreographed just, like, little things, like, you know, in my room just for fun. But I never really got to do, like, my own solo and choreograph, like, everything that I wanted and, like, actually, like, have some input.
So Zaria, I know that you do take a lot of dance classes as well. So how was this process different for you? And has the training that you've been exposed to outside of Edison and in Edison helped to shape you as a choreographer as well? You know, knowing more. So like Adriana said, you know, she only did hip hop for a long time, and now learning all of these different disciplines, you know, it gives her more of a vocabulary. So how has that sort of kind of helped you?
I started off doing hip hop too when I first started dancing, but coming to Edison in the dance program, I came in with like a mindset that I probably wasn't going to learn anything from like a 45-minute class, and I wasn't going to really take anything home from this class, and I probably wasn't going to take it the next year anyway, but total opposite. I actually love the class a lot. I think I went home with more things from this than my outside dance school, actually. I've grown to like love the girls, of course, and grown to have so many beautiful friendships and a relationship with a dance teacher. And knowing that I come to school and express myself and my emotions without being judged or anything was very different. Like they said, I was just so used to getting choreography thrown at me, being told what to do, how to do it, and just listening and not giving any back talk to anything. But being in the Edison dance program, it just opened up to my eyes of what I'm capable to do on my own without anyone telling me what I'm like told to do. That makes sense.
And overall, I think that all of you guys have grown in maturity as well. You've had ownership of this piece. You want to put your best out there, and show, and seeing you guys develop in what you did, you should absolutely be proud of what you guys accomplished. So I mean, just to see the growth in the ladies has just been, you know, just really heartwarming for me as well, and seeing how open you guys are to this experience. So it is an honor. I mean, there are, you know, I only picked five. There were, you know, I don't know, 25 solos or something that I saw. So we are going to continue this every year because I think this would be a great thing to do. Have some time to tell your stories and do it in a way that you may never have been able to do before. Zaria has been in the program 3 or 4 years, did you say? 3 years, okay. And she's a senior, and Zaria is always very creative and very expressive when she dances. And she did a beautiful piece. I kind of knew a little bit about it prior just because of all the time we've spent together. But she's going to talk about her piece, her stimuli, and how it sort of came together for her.
My stimuli was ideational, and the story meant a lot to me because it was a lot of emotions that I didn't really get to express going through what I was going through at that time, and I just brought those emotions out through this piece, and it really, really, like, opened up a new side of me that I never really knew I had. Like, I'm not really the type to cry or anything or let anybody see me down, so this piece really did let me see the vulnerable side of myself, if that makes sense.
And even though it was ideational and there was a story behind it, you kind of started with the idea of your prop, right?
Yeah.
So it was something that was also tactile to her. Do you want to talk a little bit about the prop that you use in the piece?
So, like, last September, I lost someone that was really, really important to me, my grandfather. And he's, like, my best friend. Oh. And the ashes were given to me within a necklace, and I never took the necklace off since I got it. So when I had a chance to tell a story, that's the first thing that touched home to me, because I never really got to express my feelings when I was going through the loss. I always had to keep my face trying to make my grandmother stronger, and just going through the motions with the necklace throughout the piece, it just was like a comfort throughout the dance and some of it.
So using that, you know, that tactile, something that you have and something that reminds you, really sparked, you know, the story. How was it creating this very emotional story for you? How was that process, and how was that process doing it at home over Zoom, just a few times in the studio?
So first, it was a little difficult because the song I chose, it was hard not to choreograph to the words. So that's mainly why I chose an instrumental piece, because I didn't want to go off the words. But it was even more hard to like tap into those emotions at home with a small space. But coming here to the studio and trying to open up, it, like, the process became a little easier, just making sure that I was like on the right track, told the story well. Mm-hmm. And in other like instances, when I was at home, like when I first started the stimuli, it was easy because I just went off of my emotions and just went off what I knew. But continuing the whole piece, I had to really tell a story, and that was what was really hard about it.
So. Right, and a lot of times I think it's even like as a writer, you know, you have a storyline, and then you realize, well, I have to keep this going. You know, and in movement, you know, you have to say to yourself, well, I can't just do what I'm used to, right? We always talk about the girls like, all right, don't just throw in a jump here. I would say to you, what would I say to you if you threw in something and I thought it doesn't belong there? No, but also like, why did you do that? Why is that movement there? What is that? How is that telling your story? And a lot of times I don't like them to use lyrics with their stories, because I want them to tell it, not the musicians. So great. Thank you. All right, let's go down to Ashley. She started this piece, and I was just so intrigued by what she did that I gave her one of the best compliments. I wanted to see more. So I had her develop her solo, and she's going to talk a little bit about it. So go ahead, Ashley, tell us a little bit about your stimuli and why you chose it.
Okay, so pretty much like to start this whole dancing experience with like creating my solo, the circumstances that I was going through at the time, I actually wasn't planning on doing a solo or even like creating a dance in the first place, but I decided to pull all like my circumstances that I had, all my obstacles aside, and I just said, I'm gonna try this. And I pretty much just freestyled that dance. And then afterwards, like Ms. Jenkins said herself, she liked it and she wanted to see more. So that was kind of like a challenge for me, because after I freestyled it, I had to learn it. And then just after I learned it, I felt it. And then I started creating my own story, which is the stimuli that I came up with, which is if like, so especially with everything that's going on now with like COVID and quarantine, a lot of people have been struggling like mentally or emotionally, anything like that. So my stimuli kind of reflects off missing someone or something. So it's just like having that thought that you feel alone and you just want something that brings you joy or someone that just makes you feel comfortable around yourself. So that's pretty much what my stimuli is about.
And your music choice was very different, which the audience will see. Can you talk a little bit about the music you chose?
Yeah. At first, I was kind of like, I don't know what song to use. Should I just use like an instrumental or a song that has lyrics to it? Because I don't necessarily want to dance to the lyrics because it's just like my own story. But I decided to go with a Spanish song, and then I incorporated another song, which made like a remix. And in the dance, it's like the little surprise I can't really spill right now. But yeah, I just really like what I did with like the song I chose.
Yeah, it was definitely something different, and I think the audience will really enjoy it. Great. Yeah.
Amarte, disfruto acariciarte y ponerte a dormir. Es escalofriante tenerte de frente, hacerte sonreír. Daría cualquier cosa por tan primorosa, por estar siempre aquí. Y entre todas esas cosas, déjame quererte, entrégate a mí. No te fallaré, contigo yo quiero envejecer. Quiero darte un beso, perder contigo mi tiempo, guardar tu secreto, cuidar tus momentos, abrazarte, esperarte, adorarte, tenerte paciencia, tu locura es mi vida.
Mucho dicen conocerme y es muy fácil especular y no lo juzgo, eso es humano y natural. Oye, a veces uno cree saber de los demás, pero ni un 20%, es decir, ni la mitad. Todo lo que yo he vivido, ya son 39 aquí de pie yo sigo. No pudieron mis enemigos nada. Oye, y la verdad sacando cuenta mirando al espejo, yo fui mi único enemigo. Del bareto pa' la perco, cada día más terco. Sin disciplina, ¿para qué tener talento? Pero Diosito me dio otra oportunidad. Levante la cara y no le pienso bajar. N-I-C-K.
Amarte, disfruto acariciarte y ponerte a mí. Es escalofriante tenerte de frente, hacerte sonreír.
que tengo, un gusto valorarte, nunca olvidarte, entregarte mis tiempos. No te fallaré, contigo yo quiero envejecer.
So Adriana was another one who, when I saw her solo over Zoom, I was kind of blown away even through the emotion that she was able to convey even over a camera, because it's very different when you're in front of an audience or on stage. So Adriana, why don't you talk a little bit about your piece and what your stimuli was and what motivated you.
So my stimuli was ideational, right? Okay, so it was just hard for me to try and convey it because it's such an upsetting story and a part of me that's like deep within and like, you know, so it was pretty hard, but I think conveying my emotions through helped me.
Yeah, helped you in the creative process?
Yeah.
Yeah. Was it very emotional for you?
Yes.
Yeah. So, you know, that's good. I mean, it's real. It's showing that you're showing your emotions of what your story, you know, meant to you and why you chose it. And so that process for you, did you find that it was therapeutic and that?
Yeah, it was very therapeutic. It was like calming, but I think the story made me want to show it more through my face, through my emotion. And like, yeah, it's because like at some points in the dance, I would like end up crying or something, and like I would want that to convey on stage because like the performance would be better that way, in my opinion. So it shows more of like how much it means to me than just right. A dance or a piece.
So in some ways, do you feel like at home it was almost better to start creating it there because you could be emotional and more vulnerable?
Yeah, I was definitely more vulnerable at home because I can express and create mm-hmm. myself in a safer place, even though this is the most safe space, but in a more safer environment where I feel more comfortable mm-hmm. or showing my emotions, rather like here I want to be like, oh, like, you know, I don't want to show my emotions as much.
Great. Thank you for sharing that, Adriana. Good job.
How I do, let go of a prayer for you, just a sweet word. The table is prepared for you. Wishing you Godspeed, glory. There will be mountains you won't move. Still, I'll always be there for you. How I do, I let go of my claim on you. It's a free world. You look down on where you came from sometimes, but you left this place to call home always.
This love will be
to the inside.
We have JD. Hey guys. And JD actually was able to do a lot of her piece while it was still warm out. And she went outside and she got like this big space and she was like, okay, I'm just gonna dance, forget about, like who cares if I get dirty, whatever. She was on the floor. And just her, just the way that you sort of let go and really expressed yourself, and it was so big. I just couldn't wait to see what she would do when she really developed that and had some guidance. So JD, why don't you talk a little bit about your piece?
Okay, my piece is a ideational piece. Mm-hmm. Is that what it's called? Okay, yeah. So the song is called Hostage, and it, in a way, I wanted to portray, like, I have a lot of, like, temporary people in my life, and when I made this piece, that was, like, a very sensitive topic, like, for me, so I wanted to kind of, like, be like, the people who I have now are the people who I want to stay with, and I don't want them to, like, leave, so I want to kind of hold them hostage in a way, but not really, obviously, but, like, just, like, I want them to stay with me because I really, like, do care for everyone in my life right now. I love everyone, and I don't want them to leave me, so, yeah.
Great. And did it come easy to you, choreographing this piece?
No. When I choreographed this piece, I was actually in a very low state in my life, and I really just did not even want to get up and even choreograph a solo. When she was like, let's make dances, I was like, okay, I'm just going to improv and get a grade. But then I was like, you know what? Like, I'm going to actually try to use my emotions and try to create something that I've never done before.
So. Very good. Honest. I like that.
I want to be alone. Alone with you, does that make sense? I wanna steal your soul and hide you in my treasure chest. I don't know what to do with your kiss on my neck. This feels right, so stay safe. Yeah, you feel right, so stay safe. Let me crawl inside your veins. I'll build a wall, give you a ball and chain. It's not like me to be so mean. All I wanted, just let me hold you like a hostage. Gold on your fingertips. Against my cheek, gold leaf across your lips. Kiss me until I can't speak. Gold chain beneath your shirt, the shirt that you let me wear home. It's
So, Alicia, tell us a little bit about the stimuli that you chose and why you chose that stimuli.
The stimuli that I chose was music or sound, just beats in the song. I chose that because I wanted to go past my creative boundaries, and I didn't want to just tell a story, but I wanted my body to be the music. I wanted to feel like, I wanted you to watch me and look at me like I'm an instrument.
Right, so we're interpreting, you know, the music. So she used auditory. Which was a great, great stimuli and really took her out of her comfort zone. How was the process for you creating it, especially because you weren't in the studio that much and you had to do it at home?
So when I first started creating my piece, I looked up a Kappa, like Beta fraternity moves for like step dancing. And I took that because they hit the beats on all their moves. And I started with that, and then I gradually changed my piece from a more modern piece to like contemporary, and I even added some hip-hop moves into my piece, and I just really broadened the type of dance moves I was using just so I can
develop
more of my piece.
Right. Excellent. Okay. And how was it working on it at home? Because we met a couple of times over Zoom, and then we would try to come in the studio as much as we could. So how was that process working at home without me guiding you the entire time?
I don't really have a lot of dance space in my house. I had to move my couches and my dining room table a lot. And I tried to stay in place, but I also wanted to, now that when I found out I was performing, I wanted to like use all the dance space, but I don't have a lot of space. And having Miss Jenkins there to critique me over Zoom was helpful, but also it was less helpful than it would be in person, because she would have been like touching my body, been like, do that. And it's just difficult, but I think I pulled through.